8:30 a.m. Today, we're going to be speaking about reincarnation and religion. Now, first and foremost, I want you to understand that reincarnation is not religion. Okay? And you don't have to believe in it. But it is a reality. And you will understand this as time progresses. Now then, with that being said, it should be understood that, and I don't like to use the word, but there is science behind reincarnation. Okay? And yes, science is a difficult word, and I will not go into that. Okay, so, religion and reincarnation. How about let's go into Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. Hints of reincarnation are also common in the history of Judaism and early Christianity. Information about past and future lives is found throughout the Kabbalah, which according to many Hebraic scholars represents the hidden wisdom behind the scriptures. In the Zohar, one of the principal Kabbalistic texts, it is said, the souls must re-enter the absolute substance once they have emerged, but to accomplish this, they must develop all the perfections, the germ of which is planted in them. And if they have not fulfilled this condition during one life, they must commence another, a third, and so forth, until they have acquired the condition which fits them for reunion with God. Now then, I don't like to use the word God, so we'll just use Creator, okay? Now, I am going to go a little bit further, but before I do, I am going to bring up that predictive programming TV series from the mid-1990s that I often speak of, which is Stargate SG-1. Within that series, eventually, the team members encounter these so-called priests of Origin. Okay? Origin is supposed to be a god, if you will. Now, this is where it gets a little strange, and of course, this might be where they got their idea, but then again, is it just an idea? Let's continue. According to the Universal Jewish Encyclopedia, the Hasidic Jews hold similar beliefs. In the 3rd century AD, the theologian Origen, one of the fathers of the early Christian church and its most accomplished biblical scholar, wrote, by some inclination toward evil, certain souls come into bodies, first of men, then through their association with the irrational passions. After the allotted span of human life, they are changed into beasts, from which they sink to the level of plants. From this condition, they rise again through the same stages and are restored to their heavenly place. There are many passages in the Bible itself indicating that Christ and his followers were aware of the principle of reincarnation. Once, the disciples of Jesus asked him about the Old Testament prophecy that Elias would reappear on earth. In the Gospel of St. Matthew, we read, and Jesus answered them, Elias shall truly first come and restore all things. But I say unto you that Elias is come already, and they knew him not. Then the disciples understood that he spake unto them of John the Baptist. In other words, Jesus declared that John the Baptist, who was beheaded by Herod, was a reincarnation of the prophet Elias. This is Elias which was for to come. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear. The Quran says, and you were dead, and he brought you back to life. And he shall cause you to die, and shall bring you back to life, and in the end shall gather you unto himself. Among the followers of Islam, the Sufis especially believe that death is no loss, for the immortal soul continually passes through different bodies. Jalaluddin Rumi, a famous Sufi poet, writes, "I died as a mineral and became a plant. I died as a plant and rose to animal. I died as animal and I was man. Why should I fear? When was I less by dying?" The timeless Vedic scriptures of India confirm that the soul, according to its identification with material nature, takes one of 8,400,000 forms, and once embodied in a certain species of life, evolves automatically from lower to higher forms, ultimately attaining a human body. Thus, all of the major Western religions, Judaism, Christianity, and Islam, have definite threads of reincarnation throughout the fabric of their teachings, even though the official custodians of dogma ignore or deny them. And there we have that. We'll see you back here for the next episode. Take care, one and all.